Alright guys, here you can see I used the accordion braiding up to the battery, one tie, small ties here. I drilled a mini hole, you can't really see it, a mini hole here for a mini tie wrap. Hold on a sec. There you go, a mini hole with a tie wrap to and a tie wrap over here to keep this wire under that flap away from the hinge. And then I tried forever to get this tied up underneath. It's just too hard. So I got it folded and tied right there as the final step so I can access it easier also. All right guys, I want to show you the spot I found for the wiring and what I'm doing to get this to work. So you look next to your brake booster, these two hoses, first off, they go into something which will be hard to capture on film here. Yeah, let me get maybe a flashlight. No, you can't even really see it. There's, anyway, you really gotta trust me. You can just see that little nub right there. See that? That little nub at the top of that grommet, right in the center of the pick. Okay, so you see you have two tubes, these two tubes going in it, and you have these two little blank nubs, one of which is right in the center of that picture there. Now let's go around and I'll show you where those nubs are. I trimmed a little bit of the foam above this little square that was right there, see? And there we expose the two nubs that I'm talking about. And you could never reach from the engine compartment down into that corner. So what you do is reverse push it, and you would poke your hole here, push it, the wire through from this side into that little nub that's right there. And you could then use a tongs and stuff and pull it out from behind that brake booster area. So that is the place where you could get a wire through into your cabin. Also, by the way, that is why it has those blank nipples. That's for additional conduits from the engine compartment into the cabin. They have those spare little nipples, as we call them in the GTIs, that you can slice off the top of the nipple, and then you can push the wires through. Okay, guys, I literally spent an hour and a half trying to get the wire through, so I figured I'd at least give you the courtesy of how I did it, because it's super, super pain in the butt. So as you saw probably on the previous clip, I just cut out a little 1-inch square above that existing square to get access to that thing, and I finally got the wire through. Now what I had to do was get a little 2 or 3 inch piece of coat hanger, wind it really tight with electrical tape around it, and then I would use the pliers on the end of the coat hanger, and I was pushing it and forcing it through. That's after I made a little pin, oh here it is, a little pinhole with this little pin punch. I had the wire taped to this, it didn't work, it kept slipping off, so a coat hanger was the key. Then I just took this and just forced it through, and then I came around to this side over here. Oh, here you go. There's my coat hanger. It almost slid off. I had it taped to the very top. I just made it before sliding off. And then I had to like reach with my big old needle nose right down there and just grab the tip of the coat hanger and pull it through. And lucky the wire didn't fall off. So now I have the wire from inside to through. I can probably solder something up. Or yeah, I can solder it, and I'm gonna pull it back through the other way with a really smooth solder and get all the wiring back into the engine side. part, guys. I didn't have any heat shrink that was just the right size, so I decided I'm still soldering, but I'm gonna use the electrical tape, and there's no way that's gonna break as I'm pulling it back through now to, you know, to get out all the slack from here into the engine compartment. So this will be well in on the other side. I might even be able to, depending on how much I have, even snip it. But this is sort of temporary to be able to pull this back through now, all the way into the engine compartment. All right, guys, sorry about the gardener outside, but I did get the hose, the wire pulled nice and tight. I can't even get a beam on it. Into the hole there anyway, just trust me. See, it's pulled nice and tight. Hold on a minute. All right, I think he's done. And you can see that those solders worked real nice to help me pull it through the hole up there that we talked about. So now, see what I can do here? As I mentioned before, how the relay works, the switch itself is gonna have no load on it, no amperage, it's very minor. So I think I can tap the switch itself into my radar detector hardwire, and there's no light load that's going to be on this switch, so I think that'll work. And if it blows a little tiny radar detector fuse, I can just retap it somewhere. But see, you have to use an ignition on only for the power source for the switch over here, because if you put battery power, the light is always on and it's going to drain your battery. It has to only work when the power's on. And you'll kind of have, I don't even know if that'll fit in there, but it might. That would be pretty cool. And when the ignition comes on, this light is always on. Whether or not it's switched on, it's lit up red, and you just activate it and turn it on like that. Pretty awesome. So, see, what I'm saying is these red and blue blacks do not have to go through the firewall. These can go right to the fuse box. And the relay takes the load, as we keep saying again and again. Okay, you get the point. Man, this is a lot of work, guys. All right, especially if it ends up not even working, and if I end up not even keeping it. First off, that switch will not fit in either of these holes. Second off, this top hole does not even come out. It's a solid wall, it's not poppable. And I popped out the bottom piece and the switch is way too big. So I don't want to do any permanent modifications, of course, until I really get this thing tested nicely, make sure I'm gonna keep it. I don't wanna cut a hole in my dash or anything. So I'm probably gonna rest it in a little secret fuse cover flap, a coin. Ooh, I could get the coin holder, which could be even better. But I'm just gonna put it behind the secret little flap for now, just for now. So I am gonna finish wiring it here in just a minute. So let's put the ground maybe right here on that thing right there. Okay, the ground's nice and secure. Okay, we're gonna go, let's see, the white. All we have is the red, that's the last one. So as I said, I'm going to tap it into the smaller wire here, and I'm thinking that it's not gonna blow or anything because the switch itself doesn't take any load. So we'll see if I'm right. If not, I can always think about a different fuse, but I mean, just how it works, I think I'm gonna be all right. So I'll just do a little Scotch-Brite tapper. Let me see. Yeah, I'll cut this. So I don't need the connector on the end. Screw it. I can get another connector. All right, so tapping it in here. Tap into the power source of my radar detector, which is ignition only. Get the nice channel locks ready to press this closed. Let me get a really good angle on this. Probably like that. Let me take two hands and do this right. Also called a vampire clip, because I dug those two fangs into the wire. This does not cut the wire, which is nice. It does make some slits in it, but usually when you're done with this, you can take it off and just electrical tape that little slit if you're super picky. Looks like I got everything, all three pieces connected now. The black to ground, the red tapped into a power source ignition on, and the white all the way through the firewall to the relay. This might work, guys. All right, guys, let's see what happens here. I'm gonna turn on my ignition over here. Let's watch this switch. Woo! And this was only one click. The full ignition is not on. Let's see what happens here. Hell yeah. We have a working LED. Are you serious? Now I will do, of course, a lot more detailed work, some night shots later. For now, let me turn it on and let's go look at it. Of course, I should let it run for a minute, make sure it's not gonna pop a fuse or something. I don't want that to happen like while I'm out and about. And let's see what we got here. It is, remember, it's daytime right now. Let me, oh man, my radio came on, one sec. All right, guys, I'm closing this door so we can get some good angles here, some good shots. Just like that. All right, LED only. What the hell do we got? Wow, killer. Freaking awesome. See, I was concerned that the grill would take away 50% of the light, but I mean, it doesn't seem like it. It sure doesn't seem like it. It's pretty freaking bright, pretty cool. And kind of get you back out of the glare. Man, that's probably pretty illegal. I'm sure you're not allowed to run that just driving down the street. Let me open this. Right? You guys in California can tell me, I'm sure. I'll probably get pulled over if I have that on. Not that it's blinding people, but just because cops are dicks and it's probably illegal. In all honesty, it's probably for off-road use only. Wow, fuses isn't blowing. Killer red light. Let me turn that off. And see, the light stays on anyway. Man, I really wish I can find a perfect light, and it's only going to be three simple cables to swap over to the light once I find that. You guys can even, I mean, I got 1,000 people that can help me out with the switch. Find a really good switch that some of you guys have used. I actually prefer illuminated because it's kind of cool at night and stuff. But I don't have to have illuminated if there's a really good quality switch that's not, doesn't have a light on it. I want a really nice switch. Even just a little lever, a little push button instead of a big old button, you know, just a little tiny switch, something real compact. I'd take a much smaller switch if it would fit into that square that we take out, you know, the lower square that I pop out. If someone's found one that's a perfect fit, then I just take it regardless of if it lights up or anything like that. So that's pretty much it, guys. I'm gonna assemble all this crap back up, and I'm actually gonna turn off my thing, which then turns off the light and stops draining all your power. I think we're good. That was an amazing project, guys.